Hi, John. Thank you very much for taking some time to talk to us today.
Hi, Wade. How are you doing?
I'm grand, thank you. And I'm looking forward to this. I know you are very busy. What have you been working on most recently that you can reveal to us?
Well, most recently, I've been working on the fifth book of the Siege of Terror series, which is called Mortis.
Superb. So that is a fairly heavy and ominous name. What does Mortis pretend for the Siege of Terror? What can we expect?
It's called Mortis for a few reasons. Most importantly of which, it covers the point in the siege when Horus unleashes the Legio Mortis Titans to breach the palace inner walls. So one of the parts of the book is the battle between the forces sent to try and stop the Legio Mortis reaching the wall. In particular, the Legio Ignatum, known as the Fire Wasps.
Superb. So is this introduction to writing about Titans in the Siege of Terror for you? I guess the Solar War was a little bit more space-bound.
Yeah, the Solar War was all about the space battles. And this one is my first time writing Titans, I think, overall, in a big way, in the Horus Heresy as a whole, certainly in the Siege. That was great. I've wanted to write about Titans in the Horus Heresy forever. The Legio Mortis and the Legio Ignatum, the Fire Wasps, are two of the most iconic Titan legions. If you, like me, if you remember the original Adeptus Titanicus with lots of Titans in red, with black and red stripes, though, that, you know, that's the Legio Ignatum, and those were some of my first images of Titans that I remember. And the Legio Mortis is pretty much the archetypical traitor legion, the first Titan legion really to fall directly to the powers of chaos, and the oldest as well, both in terms of the background and in terms of the lore. It was really fun to write those two.
And the Siege of Terror gives them an appropriate backdrop for that, really, like not many other battles or settings would be able to do so, to see those legions in their glory.
It's like nothing else. They've got, the Legio Mortis have been tasked with breaching a section of the wall called Mercury Wall, it's like a mountain range. It's one of the more intact pieces of the wall. And it's got layered guns, tiers and tiers of guns. And the direct line of sight from the top of the wall guns is like 130 kilometers out. And they've got to advance across that space to reach distance to wall zero. And that's before they actually try and breach the wall. And against them are going the last reserves that Rogal Dorn has held for a moment like this. So the Legio Ignatum are one of the most, one of the largest Titan legions, and certainly the most intact by this point on the Loyalist side in the siege. And so they're not just going out piecemeal. This is the entire Titan Legion that is on Terra goes out into what's called the kill zone outside of Mercury Wall to try and keep the Legio Mortis from reaching the walls. Like nothing else. It was great fun doing it, actually, even just the scale of what they're trying to do. Because we know from everything that's been written already that Rogal Dorn had flattened the land outside the palace walls in preparation for the siege to create kill zones. But as anybody that's ever tried to flatten any kind of land ever, even if it's just in the back of your garden, knows, getting something perfectly flat is really, really difficult. So there's a huge amount of sort of topography in it. It's still... It doesn't have any of the hives or the kind of settlements that were starting to spring up in that. But there are kind of gorges cut through the ground by runoff water that's come from the massive dome of shields that's over the inner palace. And there's little tangles of old dead machinery that was used to level the ground and then broke down. They didn't have the time or the resources to pull it back in the walls before everything started. So it's this strange environment that's actually got kind of lots of weird old non-literal ghosts of old terror in it as well.
So apart from the Titan Legions, did you get to write about anything else new or for the first time as part of Mortis?
It wouldn't be a siege book if we weren't writing about lots and lots and lots of different factions and characters all at once. So I got to write in this about... one of the things that was really great to go back and write about was about the normal view of humans, basically how they're fighting on the front lines. So a character called Katsuhiro, who is introduced in Guy Haley's book, The Lost and the Damned, appears again in this. And we get to see how some of the Blood Angels are working with some of the mortal troops who are defending the palace, and just how under pressure the legions are at this point, that it's really difficult for them to deploy en masse without leaving huge vulnerabilities across the defences.
So you said the Legio Mortis present one reason for the book's title. Can you give us a clue as to any of the others?
The other one is death, really. The book is about despair and death, really, and that starting to overwhelm the loyalist defenders of the palace. Everything is starting to unravel for them. In Saturnine, you have this sort of tinged by incredible sacrifice high point for the defenders. They managed to hold Saturnine, which might have ended the siege in a single assault, but at the expense of now the traitors holding both the starports. And that's their high point. And then from then on, everything starts to unravel, because basically within the warp, the forces of two things, one of which is just the despair at living through this kind of cataclysmic event, is starting to eat away at people's psyches. The promise of inevitable death is eating away at people. How long can this go on? Can we ever win? Is it worth it? It's starting to crush them at all different levels. And that's manifested in particular by the Death Guard and the oncoming ascendancy of Mortarion. Although we don't see so much of that in this book, that's something that will get increasingly acute as it goes on. And on the other side of it, you've got this promise of paradise, which is literally infecting people's dreams, and calling them towards this impossible promise of a paradise that will allow them to escape this horrific, endless, grinding warfare in unimaginable conditions. Mortis is about the switch point between the old ways, the Legion War, and the war between humanity and the raw forces of chaos, because that's increasingly what they're up against.